Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at Gibbs free energy. Now, we've been talking about the system and the surroundings, and we've been talking about entropy, and to a lesser extent, delta H, enthalpy. Now we're going to take a look at the last major variable, our delta G value. We're going to say we know that according to the second law of thermodynamics, a spontaneous reaction will be when delta S total, or delta S universe, is greater than zero. But now we're going to bring into the mix delta G. Besides looking at delta S total, it's also great to look at delta G, because knowing the sign for delta G will be a great way to determine if your reaction is spontaneous or not overall. Now, to do this, we use two different equations. Here, we'll take a look at the one on the left side. It says delta G zero equals delta H zero minus T delta S zero. Remember, these zero means that we're under standard conditions. And when it comes to thermodynamics, standard conditions means 1 atmosphere and 25 degrees Celsius. And then on the other side, we have delta G equals delta G zero plus RT ln Q. Here, this would be delta G under non-standard conditions. So we're not at 1 atmosphere, or our temperature is not 25 degrees Celsius. Here, it equals delta G zero again. R here is our gas constant, which is 8.314 joules over moles times K. T is our temperature in Kelvin. Q is known as our reaction quotient. And we're going to see our reaction quotient is just products over reactants. We're going to say when it comes to Q, it ignores two states of matter. It ignores solids and liquids. So if it's a solid or liquid, it ignores it. If it's aqueous or gaseous or gas, it will look at them. Okay, so ignore solids and liquids, but look at aqueous and gases. Now we're gonna say here, if delta G under non-standard conditions is less than zero, then our reaction is spontaneous. If it's greater than zero, then it's non-spontaneous. And if it's equal to zero, then our reaction is at equilibrium. Now, let's take a look at example one. And when it comes to this particular type of example, this is a standard type of question for any exams that you take that deal with delta G, delta H, and delta S. So remember our techniques that we use here in order to solve this particular type of question. Since we're going to need room to see everything, I'm going to remove myself from the image, guys, so we have more room to work with. So the question says, which of the following statements is true for the following reaction? So we have N2O4 gas breaks down to give us 2NO2 gas. We're going to say here the delta H value is negative, the delta S value is positive. And then we'll see that our options are, the reaction could be spontaneous or non-spontaneous, depending on the types of temperatures we're talking about. Now, in your book, there's going to be a long, large chart where you have to memorize different things. Now, I say you can look at the chart, but there's a much easier way to handle a question like this. That has to do with the little square thing that we have to the right side. So here we're going to use this image to help us figure out how to answer this question easily without having to learn a huge chart. So here we're going to say we have our delta S values on top. They're positive and negative. On the sides, we have our delta H values, positive and negative. Now here's the thing, we're going to say when both delta H and delta S are positive, then our reaction is spontaneous at high temperatures. At high temperatures. If delta H is positive and delta S is negative, then it's non-spontaneous at all temperatures. So non at all temperatures. If delta H is negative and delta S is positive, then we're going to say they're spontaneous at all temperatures. So spon at all temperatures. Then finally, if delta H and delta S are both negative, then it's only spontaneous at low temperatures. Okay. So it's going to be high, non, spon, low. Easy way to remember. Now, if we go back to the question, we have a delta H that's negative, a delta S that's positive. So when delta H is negative and delta S is positive, they say that the reaction is spontaneous at all temperatures. Okay. A question like this is very basic on your exam, so it's important you guys remember this quick, easy technique. Instead of having to sit down and memorize an entire graph, an entire chart in your book, just simply use this diagram. You can easily answer the question. The hard part really is just remembering who goes on the top, who goes on the side. Just remember, delta S values are on top, delta H's are on the side, then it's high, non-spon, low. And that's all it is. An easy way to break down a very complicated issue. So just remember the steps, remember how to draw this diagram, and you'll be fine when it comes to a question like this.